Welcome to the Sun Parlour Coffee House Sessions. I'm Jan Hall. Joining us in the studio for this episode, we have Justin Latam from Leamington. Justin's been making music for over 10 years now and released his fifth album, Barefoot, in 2015. And he's coming up right now. Enjoy.
All right, the first song I'm going to share with you guys is a tune called Life's Better on the Porch. And one of my favorite things to do when the weather is fine out is spend time on the front porch.
I've put in my time, honest work for an honest dime. Now it's time to slow it down. Got me a little slice of my own paradise right outside my front door. Life is good when the working day is done. Life is good, so let's have a few cold ones. Let's kick back, let's unwind, have some good old-fashioned fun. Life is good, but you know, life's better on the porch. I don't have to move from here. My mason jar is full of beer. I ease into my favorite chair. Yes, I'm perfectly fine watching the world go by right outside my front door. Life is good when the working day is done. Life is good, so let's have a few cold ones. Let's kick back, let's unwind, have some good old-fashioned fun. Life is good, but you know, life's better on the porch. If I worry about tomorrow all the time, then I'm missing out today's peace of mind. And I know it's easier said than done. Let's give it a shot, give it all we've got. Got me a little slice of my own paradise right outside my front door. Life is good when the working day is done. Life is good, so let's have a few cold ones. Let's kick back, let's unwind, have some good old-fashioned fun. Life is good, but you know, life's better on the porch. Some nights I go and take her out. My wife don't fuss, no, she don't shout. When I take out my other baby, my late night lady on the side. Some nights she gets my drinks for free, and I get her screaming and singing for me. I'm talking about my other baby, my late night lady on the side. She's my late night lady on the side. side. My wife's alright with it, she don't mind. Long as I come home to sleep, all's well. She don't ask, and I don't tell. Tell her about my other baby, my late night lady on the side. She really gets me a sweating. Hands all over her makes me smile when I'm fretting. I'm talking about my other baby, my late night lady on the side. She's my late night lady on the side. My wife's alright with it, she don't mind. Long as I come home to sleep, all's well. She don't ask, and I don't tell. Tell her about my other baby, my late night lady on the side. Oh yes, I know she's made of wood, but she sure keeps me satisfied. I'm faithful to both of my babies, both my guitar and my wife.
This next tune is one I wrote for my lovely wife, who has just an amazing voice when she sings. And it's just a song I wrote to remind and encourage her to sing more often. So it's called When You Sing.
You could sing the grocery list to me, and it would be holy. Would become a hymn to the pilgrimage of nourishment for our family. You could sing the bills to me, we'd still be broke and in the hole, but at least the sun would be shining down from your golden voice. You could sing the day's weather report to me, and even if we'd planned on going to the beach and it was pouring rain, be okay, 'cause you'd be singing. You could sing the menu to me at a restaurant where the food is questionable at best, and it would sound as appealing as a fancy 5-star 3-fork place. Because when you sing, it brings flowers into bloom, and when you sing, brightens up this darkened room, and when you sing, tides will even turn and abandon the moon. Yes, for you, when you sing, when you sing. Sing in a church hall and have no problem at all, filling the emptiness with the voice of an angel, beautiful as anything can be. You could sing in some dive roadhouse bar and have no problem getting down and dirty with the blues, bending notes that make toes curl inside their shoes. And I love when you sing in the car, watch you in my periphery and think that you don't notice me noticing you, but you do. And I love when you sing to our children, my heart melts each time, and I'm endeared to you ever more than before. If that's possible, yeah, it's possible. When you sing, it brings flowers into bloom, man. Sing, brightens up this darkened room, and when you sing, tides will even turn and abandon the moon. Yes, for you, when you sing. And it makes me sad to my bones through and through when you think that you're not good enough singing the way you do.
Well, this next song is written about that time. If you have kids and they're ready to go off into the world and do their own thing, that's what this song's about. And in my own house, my wife and I have 5 children, and our oldest is in grade 12 this year. So this really isn't too far off for me. So this song is called Call Home.
What a privilege it's been to walk beside you as you've grown. Now it's time for you to find the path that's all your own. Though I've let go of your hand, I'm only as far as a phone. Please call home, call home. Please call home. I know you weren't mine to keep, but a precious gift on loan. You grew up so quickly, how the time has flown. I'm so proud of who you've become, love you more than you know. Please call home, call home. Please call home, call home. The road is long, the road is hard, with twists and bumps and turns. And every challenge that you face is a chance for a lesson learned. All along I thought it was I teaching you, but you've taught me so much in all that we've been through. Troubles in the world, it's still a beautiful place. And I'm reminded of that when I see your shining face. And I'll celebrate your footsteps wherever you may roam. Please call home, call home. Please call home, call home. Please call home, please call home, call home.
That's Justin Latam with Call Home live in the Sun Parlour Coffee House studio today. It's great to have you join us, Justin.
Oh, thank you for having me.
Now, I've got to be honest, I'm amazed that you've been making music for over 10 years. I was reading through your bio when we came here, and it's like, he's only 30, he's been making music for over 10 years, he's got 5 kids at home.
Yeah.
A busy life.
It's
great to have you join us, and I know, having seen you perform live, how important it is for you to be able to share your music with people. When we have an interview like this, it's a great opportunity to get to know you. And I think the first question I have to ask is, tell us a little bit about why you wanted to get into music.
Well, I grew up, my parents had a wonderful record collection. So from the time I was a baby, there was always great music around. And then in grade 4, my brother and I got guitars and started guitar lessons at Dale's Music Room when he had it in town, and started writing when I was a teenager, and I just couldn't stop.
And I think your father plays as well, is that right?
He does. He plays guitar, and then he also plays percussion along with me at a lot of my shows.
So it must have been a very musical household when you were growing up.
I do remember my dad playing guitar a little bit, when we were young.
Yeah. I was surprised. I mentioned at the start of the show, 5 albums already. Barefoot was the last one in 2015. Do you find it very easy to write songs?
I find it comes and goes. Sometimes I'll have times when I'm writing a dozen songs at once. And then, like right now, for instance, I'm in a kind of a drought. So I'm waiting for that next phase. But I'm always writing, even if I don't have anything really inspiring. I try to keep the machine going so that when the inspiration does hit, be able to let it out more easily.
Now, the interesting thing you said was that you're in a drought, but I noticed that all of the songs you've chosen to play for us today, they're all new songs.
Yes,
I thought
they are.
Yeah. So you already have 5 songs for the next album.
I do. I actually have about 20. So I've kind of been picking and choosing, and it's nice to have more than you need so you can pick the best.
Now, you're playing solo with us tonight, but I know when I've seen you play live, you often play with a band. What is your preference? I mean, is it a situation where it depends on the audience where you'll be playing, whether you choose to go solo or with a band?
Yeah, it totally depends on the audience and also which songs I'm doing at the show. Some songs are more suited for like a more intimate solo performance, but some are just jams, and you want to have all those different guys around you kind of feeding the energy off each other.
Now, one of the things I learned when I was reading about you is the fact that you're very creative when it comes to coming up with ideas to raise a little bit of money for your music. You're quite happy to do tours where I think this past summer you were doing a porch tour, and I think you've done other things like that to try and bring some money in that you can put up into music. Can you talk a little bit about that?
Sure. So I think it kind of started when I was getting ready to do my Barefoot album. And my wife had the great idea that, why don't you do like a house concert thing where you pass the hat and it's really intimate, right? You get to go to different people's houses and share your own songs. And it was really a lot of fun. So I just kept it going and did another one. And I'm still doing it. So if anyone's interested.
You mentioned Barefoot, and I've got to ask you. Tell us a little bit about the Barefoot thing, because I know, having had a chance to listen to the Barefoot album and the wonderful video that accompanies that song that I'm sure a lot of people have seen, going barefoot seems to be very important to you, and obviously it saves on shoes. But tell us a little bit about how you got into that.
Well, it's really the way I was raised. My mom was at home with us when we were growing up, and she was always barefoot. And we lived out in the county, so we were always outside playing barefoot, and it kind of just stuck with me, and it feels good. So, yeah.
And so every time you play, you play barefoot?
I do. Every show, I'm always barefoot, and it feels good to be able to kind of, like, I move a little bit when I'm playing, so it feels more natural to have my feet on whatever surface is under me, and easier to get in the groove.
And do you go out, I have to ask this question, do you go out in the winter barefoot, or you put shoes on?
No, I do. I do put shoes on. I love my feet, and I don't want them to, get too cold or anything, so I do I do put shoes on, but it just makes it all that much more appreciative for me when I get to take my shoes off.
Yeah. Tell us a little bit about your influences and who are the people that you really feel have inspired you as far as your music is concerned.
Well, my my favorite songwriter is Leonard Cohen. And it really, his writing kind of showed me, you know, you can find your own voice. And so my writing doesn't necessarily mimic his, but I've kind of used him as an inspiration to find my own voice. And then also another big influence on me is the local folk singer, Dale Butler, and just everything he's done for the local community.
I never heard of him.
No. Well, you should check him out. He's pretty good.
Yeah. No, but seriously, so Dale has been a big influence for you?
Yeah, I took lessons at his store, and then he's always kind of checking in to see how I'm doing, and he's just a great guy.
Yeah. What are your aspirations for the future as far as your music is concerned?
Well, I'm just going to keep on writing because I can't stop. So I'm going to keep writing and just keep making more records and sharing my music with people and try to make people happy. You know?
Now, I know you've been down to Nashville, I think, a few times to, you know, to work on your songwriting. This is something that obviously you're really passionate about. Do you hope that, you know, at the moment, I think you're quite well known in southwestern Ontario. Are you hoping that eventually you'll be able to broaden your opportunities, you know, perhaps being able to play further across Canada and into the States?
I would definitely keep my options open. And if opportunities came up, I would love to take my music, kind of, well, let it take me where it wants to. And I think it would be cool.
Yeah, that's great. Well, we've got time for one more song, but I should just ask you, if people want to learn more about your music, how can they do that?
They can go to my website, which is justinlatam.com. I also have my music on CD Baby, which is another website, but you can find that link on my actual website, and you can find shows and pictures and videos and all that good stuff on my website.
Well, it's been great to have you join us today. As I mentioned, we've got one song left. What are you going to play for us?
I'm going to play What You Leave.
Justin Latam with What You Leave in the Sun Parlour Coffee House Studio. Thanks.
You're welcome.
When I was growing up, pool was always something that was really big in our house, and it was a game that my dad loved to play. And something he always said when we played pool was, it's not what you get, it's what you leave. So that's the inspiration for this next tune, and it takes my take on what it means, what you leave.
But a lad, I shot pool with my old man. He introduced me to the game. From bar to bar we played. He's a man of few words, but this he'd often say, it's not what you get, it's what you leave. 'Cause what you get when the balls roll from the break is uncertainty. Can I up your table and call your shots? There's no guarantee. Just stay true, follow through, and there's a bigger picture to see. It's not what you get, it's what you leave. It's what you leave. Now I am a man full grown with children of my own. Haven't touched a cue in at least a year or two. With the sunrise each day I try and see the game. It's not what you get, it's what you leave. 'Cause what you get when the balls roll from the break is uncertainty. You can't eye up your table and call your shots. There's no guarantee. Just stay true, follow through, and there's a bigger picture to see. It's not what you get, it's what you leave. it's what you leave. Side of the ground, but the best part of me will carry on with my family. So I live, love, laugh, let my epitaph read. It's not what you get, it's what you leave. 'Cause what you get when the balls roll from the break is uncertainty. Can I at the table and call your shots? But there's no guarantee. Just stay true, follow through, and there's a bigger picture to see. It's not what you get, it's what you leave. 'Cause what you get when the balls roll from the break is uncertainty. Can I at the table and call your shots? But there's no guarantee. Just stay true, follow through, and there's a bigger picture to see. It's not what you get, it's what you leave. It's what you leave.
I think I could get used to this.
Awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm already starting to feel more musical.
Perfect.
That's great. Well, we should say goodbye.
We should.
From the Sun Parlour Coffee House Sessions.
A barefoot goodbye.
Goodbye. Justin Latam. Justin Latam has been making music for over 10 years now and released his fifth album, Barefoot, in 2015. And he's coming up right now. Enjoy. Is that okay?
No, it was terrible.
It could have been terrible.